I'm not an expert, but I understand it, the whole idea behind a shark cage is that it's supposed to actually keep the sharks out of the cage.
You're right, and it didn't work that way for two tourists staring into the jaws of a great white. The man who shot this video is talking about those frightening moments. ABC's Tanya Rivera has the story.
It was the honeymoon that nearly turned into a horror show. When a newlywed enters a shark cage off the coast of South Africa, the great white doesn't stick to the script.
Whoa!
Watch again carefully. You can see the great white thrust its entire head inside the bars of the cage. Ignoring food left for bait, the massive beast charges straight through the cage. Fellow tourist Brian Plummer recorded this newlywed meets shark video that has now gone viral.
I think he kind of joked he was unsure if he was going to tell her what had happened that day.
Look again at those gaping, deadly jaws.
He went through.
For a few terrifying seconds, the diver's fate is unknown.
Are you okay?
We see a little bit of, some red gets kicked up in the water, and my heart definitely stopped. I think it's really easy to kind of assume the worst.
Cage diving is a popular tourist activity in the seas where sharks abound. But how safe is it?
I think that if the cage is sturdy, cage diving in and of itself isn't dangerous. But when it comes to feeding, anytime you feed a wild animal, there are risks.
Regardless, you'll need to keep your wits about you.
So Roger did say that he did swim under the viewing bar, or the area that you can look out. His instinct was to just go down and avoid where the shark had access to. Very quick thinking.
Everyone is fine. We contacted that cage diving company in Hansbaai, South Africa. They tell us in 16 years, they've never seen anything like this, but they will now be making the viewing gaps on their cages smaller so it won't happen again. My husband, Chris, actually went cage diving in that exact same spot, Dan and Brianna.
Really?
Yeah. He said it was fun, but he doesn't need to do it again.
Yeah, I now know what I'm not going to do on my next
I'm never doing it right.
Thank you, Tanya.